live in that and actually work from that point? Is it spending time with family and friends? Is your life what you had imagined it to be? Are there some things you want to change? Are there some things that you want to go ahead and improve? What are these little small nuances in your life that you wanted to go ahead and change or grow? Do you want to become better at your job? Do you want to become a better parent? Do you want to learn how to speak another language? Do you want to be a better friend? Do you want to be a better wife or husband? What is it that you want to become better? Just think about it. What's something that you, an area in your life that you actually want to grow in? And this can go beyond just, you know, your personal life. It's, you know, what kind of car do you want to have? What kind of job would you like to have? What kind of career do you have? Are you happy in the career that you are in now? Are you utilizing your best talents to add more value in the industry that you're in? Does it give you that opportunity? Are you aware of the opportunities that are there? You know, when you wake up in the morning, what do you think about? Do you feel fulfilled in your life, or do you feel a hunger that there's something more that you were meant for, something more that you actually wanted to do, something more you actually wanted to complete in your life? When you imagine your life as it is, as you want it to be, not just as it is, understanding where you are is simply where you are, where you want your life to be, where you're imagining it to be in the future. What does that look like? Like in detail, what does it look like? What do you see around you? And does what you see around you match what's going on in your head? Now, if they don't match, that's perfectly fine. That's actually a good sign that you understand that there's still room for you to grow. There's still an area in your life that you want to go ahead and grow in, that you need to go ahead and change, and that you go ahead and improve. And that's perfectly fine, because just remember, like, this is all a journey. There is no finish line. Even if you do have everything that you need, or you are in your life where you want to be, still going to be asking yourself, well, what's next? What's the next level? What's the next area that I can go to? In the morning when you're opening up your eyes, are you excited? This is a day that's going to be awesome. Are you actually excited about the day that you're about to go through? Are you enthusiastic and optimistic and just completely just in awe and complete gratitude for the day that you're about to have, and it being appreciative of the day that's coming so that you can experience it and enjoy it fully? Are the things that you're working on or that you're looking forward to, do they excite you? Do they give you the juice? Do they give you the energy that tells you, you know, I'm ready to take on and tackle the world? You're waking up and you're actually excited about the project that you're going to be working on for the day. Do you feel that you're actually contributing something on a larger level, something that's more than just about yourself? Do you feel that level that you're actually giving something, giving your highest purpose, giving your highest talents? Do you feel that you're giving these things to the world and actually breaking through those challenges and breaking through new opportunities to make sure that you're actually giving what you were come here, what you've chosen to actually give the world? Is that something that you experience, that you hear in the morning every single time you wake up? Is that something that juices you, that makes you feel like, okay, I'm in an area, I'm in a place that helps rejuvenate me? You know, if it's the sound of the birds that help you feel that you're actually in the right place, then that's something to consider. That's definitely something that you should be considering. Or do you hear the sound of children playing and cars honking and dogs barking? Like, what do you hear in the mornings when you wake up? When you look out of your window, what's visible? What's in your line of sight? Is it the ocean waves that are crashing against the shore? Is it the trees and the green and the light rays from the sun that pass through? What is it? Is it a valley? Is it a huge, vast, beautiful valley that's right there overhead that you can just see the horizon? Is what you see around you something that brings you joy? Something that brings you pleasure? It's important. It's important to look around at your surroundings and ask yourself, is this where I want to be? It's hugely, hugely important. If the answer is yes, good job. But if your answer is no, well, we know that there's something more that we're striving for. And that's the beauty of it. is that we're constantly growing, that we're constantly expanding, that we're constantly opening ourselves up to something new, to something greater, and allowing ourselves to really grow, to become that to which that we can really step into and actually experience it for our own selves, experience it with our own two eyes. We actually do spend a lot of time trapped, like in a loop, by thoughts, experiences that we've had maybe in our childhood. Maybe you've had something growing up. I remember being a kid and I was actually imagining what I wanted my life to be like. Granted, I was still a child, but I still had these visions, like these ideas about where I wanted to be and where I wanted to live and the things that I wanted to experience and actually see and feel and hear and smell and taste and touch. All of these things actually crossed my mind as I began to grow. Even while younger, there are still a lot of things that I wanted to learn, that I wanted to become, that I wanted to see the world, the different parts of the world that I wanted to see, that I wanted to really, really capture. Your brain will work as a time machine. Your brain, you can actually reflect and look back. It's kind of like, you know, you being in a relationship and then that relationship ends and time, you've given some time to pass and you've healed and you've moved on. What happens is you actually begin to look backwards and you have a tendency to notice more things that you appreciated about that person than the things that you didn't appreciate about that person. Simply because you've moved on and you've grown, hopefully you've healed and you've become better and you're much happier. Not because you're out of that relationship, but simply because you've chosen to become happier. You've chosen not to allow yourself to be stuck and lived in the past, and you've actually become happier and you've grown. When I look back on my life, I begin to notice little things that I appreciated growing up, and all these little gems and nuggets of wisdom and experiences and all those things that I kind of like, I keep with me so that I can use them as tools for the future. Now, in order to do this, in order to really, really focus on that one single thing that's going to matter, that one single thing, that one focus, your compass, your North Star, we'll call it, your North Compass, one single North Star that really pulls you. Now, one of the most important things that you have to remember that your mindset, the way that you're actually thinking, your psychology is going to be hugely, hugely important. Have an attitude of something that you can do something, or that you get to do something, not that you just have to do something. By getting to do something, when you feel like you get to do something rather than you have to do something, there's a bubbliness, there's an aliveness to that. There's a huge aliveness to feeling like that you get to do something rather than you have to do something. Another key thing that's really gonna help is being passionate. When you're passionate about something, it's not a word. It's, you can't explain how you're passionate about it. You just express it. I think passion is something that is expressed through the conviction of your emotion, your physiology, your body language, your eye contact, your tonality, your focus, your discipline. That's passion. All of those elements are recipes that make up passion. It's not just, you know, talking about something emotionally and be like, you know, I'm really passionate about this subject. I'm just so passionate about it. Now, that's just my opinion. Passion is something that I think it's kind of like a germ that grows within you over time. And sometimes, you know, you might try something out initially and you might not feel anything for it. But the more you do it, or the more you understand it, or the more you relate to it, or the more emotional intensity that gets involved with it, it slowly becomes a passion. You really can't force passion. Passion is something that you're willing to suffer for, whether it be mentally, physically, in order to make sure that the big picture end in mind of what you're truly after, that it's worth it in the long run. And you're not doing it for anybody else, you're just doing it for yourself. Even if you weren't being paid for it, you're still doing it because you don't need to be rewarded, you don't need confirmation, you don't need... Passion is a self-fulfilling prophecy. It's something that you are generating from the inside. And when you're passionate about something, your brain will find the tools, the resources, the ideas, you'll meet the right people, you will notice things in your environment that relate to what it is that you're focused on. It completely seeps from your pores when you're really passionate about something. It's just something that kind of just like flows out of you. Another thing that's important is having resilience. Resilience is huge. when these obstacles and these things are surfacing and they're happening, we usually don't know where they come from or when they're gonna happen. But when they strike, you have to be able to fall down 9 times and get up 10, as you may have heard before. And it's something that it takes a certain strength, a certain energy, a certain willpower, and to make a decision that no, I will not suffer, I will not sit, I will not wait, I will not back down, I will pursue and I will persist on through no matter what challenges, what storms, no matter what happens throughout the course of this experience, I will pursue and I will find a way to make it happen. That is huge resilience. Resilience is mandatory because life is constantly going to challenge you. People are going to challenge you. Your work is going to challenge you. Your health is going to challenge you. Your mental and physical endurance is going to challenge you. That's just a part of life. That's a part of the rules of life. You will be challenged. As long as you're willing to go through that challenge, then there's a lot more that you will become when you actually break through to the other side. You become more than what you think you were, especially the good feeling, the great feeling of breaking through those chains, of breaking through those barriers, of becoming much more than you thought that you could become. That is something huge, and that is something extremely valuable, and that's something that's required in order for you to hit that next level or even to get to that next step in order to make it happen. When things are happening around you, you can find a way to enjoy the process. It's hugely important to enjoy the process, or you could even score the journey with the music, with soundtrack, with something to get your blood going, or something that causes you to intensify your focus, or something that invokes positive and resourceful emotions. All of these things are tools that you can actually use. And it doesn't matter what the people around you think about you, or they might make fun of you, and they might say, oh, well, you know, look at this guy. Who does he think he is? Or who does she think she is? None of that really matters, because everyone will have their own struggles that they have to deal with. If they even have the time to sit around and point out what you're doing wrong, then clearly they're not making progress in their own lives. Because the very thought of just pointing out what someone is doing wrong and not delivering a solution means they probably have the same pattern in their life of pointing out things that are going wrong, but they're not finding an effective solution. What does the best version of myself look like? What does living on the edge? What does being in a peak state? What is being in the vortex? What is being in the flow? What is that like? What does that look like? Just paint a picture of it. What do you see? What do you feel? What do you hear? What do you smell? What are some things that really have you performing and experiencing the best? What does that look like? What would that feel like? How would you use your body? If you could imagine yourself in 5, 10, 15 years. Hell, if you can imagine yourself in 6 months, in 3 months, in a month, tomorrow, what do you look like? How do you act? How do you show up? How do you contribute? How do you break into and break through? What are these little nuances? What are these things? What are these things that you can give, that you can be? How will you give yourself to the world completely? What are these things? How will you use your strengths? How will you use your gifts? How will you use your talents? And how will you use all of the assets that's been given to you to create a life of wonder, to create a life of excellence, to create a life of growth, to take one small step, to take one small step closer to who you will ultimately become. These things may include eliminating certain words from your vocabulary, like, I won't, I shouldn't, and replacing with things like I must, I will. Words have a lot of power. Our vocabulary, the words that we use on a regular basis, are a huge reflection of what's going on internally. The life that's in your language will last a lifetime. Are you healing with your words? Or are you harming with your words? In order to become the best of who you truly are, don't worry about what other people think. You don't have to compare yourself to anyone else. No one else is compared to you. When you just focus on your purpose and what's important to you, when you really give that gift, when you give that from the heart, you just give, what happens is that your passion, your audience, your gifts, whatever you are owed will find you. Yes, it requires patience, it requires time, it requires diligence, but it is something that will show up as long as you are persistent. But don't give up the bigger vision. Always stay in alignment with that. Always keep going, always keep moving forward. As you're making progress toward your goals, the only person that will ever know whether you are actually fulfilling that, whether you're giving your all, is you. You're the only person who knows. Your boss doesn't know. Your wife and kids won't know. Your family doesn't know. Your colleagues won't know. You're the only person that will actually know whether you're actually giving 100%, whether you are aligned with that one thing or not. You don't have to understand every single thing about something to get started. Sometimes you have to learn as you go. If there's an opportunity for you to learn as you go, that's perfectly fine. Even if you know just 20%, that's enough to get started. You can figure out the other 80%. Whether it's from your own experience or from somebody else's or a collection of people, it doesn't matter. Always be focusing and finding ways to add value, finding ways to make progress in your chosen direction. Being able to focus like a laser. It's all about progress. Speed will come naturally. The more you do something, the better you're gonna get, the faster you're gonna get. But it's all about progress. It's all about those little micro steps that we make over time. Making those inch by inch progress in small increments every day. Making a little bit more progress closer to your goal. Progress over perfection always. Anything that humans make is not going to be perfect because we're not perfect. So it's impossible for us to make something perfect. There's a story of a painter. And he had an apprentice. The painter was a grand master. Every single brushstroke he did was just the art of excellence. One day, his student and him were painting in the studio. And the student looked over to the master and said, "Master, how do you make the perfect painting?" And the master replied, "By becoming perfect and then painting naturally." When we make progress, we feel like we've actually done something. But when we try to make something perfect, we wind up frustrated because there's always gonna be things that we're gonna notice in the long run. Maybe there's a blemish, maybe there's a certain section we could have done better, maybe we could have, you know, did more research, maybe we could have spent more time on a certain aspect, certain parts of the process. Perfection is something that's constantly eluding us. It's not something that we're gonna really attain, but it doesn't mean that we can't strive for it. Making something as perfect as it can be in that moment, but like I said, it's always progress that's going to beat perfection. We have a tendency to try to do something perfect and then we'll give up and say, "Oh, this is perfect, this is done, I don't have to touch it ever again, it's perfect." Compared to someone who's actually just looking forward to making progress, well then, now they're constantly improving. They're in a state, they have a process of constant and never-ending improvement. And they'll always beat their best because they're constantly improving. When we feel have a sense of true accomplishment, like we've done something, we've surpassed our previous goals, it's setting a milestone and doing something greater than what we had done in the past to make sure that we have actually follow through in that area. When you feel like you've done something, that you've accomplished a lot, that you've actually made huge leaps and bounds toward what it is that you are really, really focused on building and actually on doing, is to having that true sense of moving beyond your comfort zone. When you move beyond your comfort zone, you have a true sense of accomplishment, that you've stretched yourself, that you've actually broken a mold on something that you have been doing in the past. That's something hugely insanely valuable and something that you can always use to kind of measure. So there are three things that we want to take away today. You must embrace a new mindset. You must develop and train yourself into a mindset that says, I must. Number two, you create your own reality and you do it with your thoughts. Your thoughts are a reflection of how you show up. Your thoughts will guide your eyes. Your thoughts will guide your actions, especially your unconscious beliefs. And number three, no matter what's going on in your life or where you are, you can always develop a singular focus. You can always choose that one single thing to focus on that will propel you and that will pull you forward to who you were really meant to be. And that is by choice. That's it for today's episode. So hope you enjoyed it. And just remember, the light at the end of the tunnel may be you.